In this video, let's learn how to check for linear independence. Let's start with this equation here. V1 and Vk, they are vectors. C1 and Ck, they are scalars. The vectors V are independent only if all Cs, C1, C2, Ck, they are all zeros. In other words, this equation here has to be true. All Cs are equal zero. Let's assume that C1 is not zero, can be any number. In this case, you can write V1 as a linear combination of other vectors. That means the vectors are dependent in this case. Let's work in a more concrete example. This is the vector U, vector V, and the vector W. If you want to check if they are independent, we need the scalars x, y, and z equals zero. Suppose x different than 0, then in this case you can write u as a function of v and w. In this case, the vectors are not independent. U, v, and w, they are given. Therefore, our job now is to determine if they are independent or if they are dependent. This vector equation, it's equivalent to this matrix equation. See that this is the vector u, this is the vector v, and this is the vector W. Remember that for matrix multiplication, you take this first row and multiply by this column. You take the second row and multiply this column. And you take the third row and multiply by this column. How we can see that this column, X, Y, and Z, is equal zero? Only if I can remove this matrix here. That means only if there is an inverse for this matrix. Let's import SymPy, and let's define the matrix, 3 rows and 3 columns. This is the first row, this is the second row, and this is the third row. Now, let's calculate the determinant of this matrix. And the result is minus 26, that's different than 0. That means we can conclude that this matrix here is invertible, there is the inverse. Then we can conclude that the vectors U, V, and W, they are linearly independent. Let's get the inverse for fun. This matrix here has the power of removing this matrix here. And whatever you multiply by the right side, you get zero. Therefore, you get that X, Y, and Z equals zero. Now, let's work with the vector V1, vector V2, and vector V3. And let's calculate the determinant. We get zero. We know that we cannot invert this matrix here. That means the vectors are dependent. See that this equation is true. V3 is a linear combination of V1 and V2. V3 is exactly 2 times V1 and 3 times V2. You can pause the video and check. If you take V1 here and multiply by 2, and take V2 and multiply by 3 and sum up these 2 vectors, you get V3, that's here. And if you ask the computer to calculate the inverse of the D matrix, we get this error here. Matrix determinant equals zero, not invertible.